Here you guys go.
Here are our new pens. We like them. Here, Bruno, give this to Michelle. No, I don't
detach
know.
Detach it front, you detach it in for your eyes.
Oh, I did see it. See? Thank you for doing
it. And since I also used some bird devices, this is one thing I didn't have for Margarita. My kids are laughing at me. Awesome thing.
I'm walking on it. I'm walking on it.
Why don't you want to Thank you. Check one. Check one, two, two, two. Thank you.
two, check two.
Good evening. Welcome to the Fullerton College Faculty Dance Concert. My name is Melanie K. Rosa, and I'm the artistic director of tonight's show. I am proud to say that this is my 31st show that I've directed, and you're in for a great show. The dancers have been working extremely hard. The choreographers have created wonderful pieces. The lighting designer has also created amazing visuals for you, so you'll really appreciate tonight. And I would, without further ado, I would like to introduce you to Michael Hernandez. The assistant director of the show. He started out years ago as the student assistant director, and he's now moved up. I think the last 2 years he's been the assistant director, which is wonderful. He does so much behind the scenes to make this show happen. You can't even imagine. And besides being a director, he's also a wonderful performer. So you're going to see him tonight performing, which will be wonderful. Yes. Oh, you guys are all excited about that, huh? Okay, there's a few things we'd like to talk to you about. Please, we have someone that is videotaping the show. Please do not videotape the show. It's being live streamed actually tonight, and we will have a recording of the show, and we can share that with the dancers that are dancing, your family and friends. I'm not trying to be mean, but it's just for respect out of people in the theater, because, you know, honestly, if you're videotaping someone, the people behind you, all they see is a screen in the dark theater, so it looks like a flashlight. So what you're doing is, although you're seeing this wonderful vision of, you know, the performance on stage, they're being distracted by your video, right? So please don't do it, okay? And I trust me, if you want me to share the link, just ask one of your dancers. I actually shared the link last night at 12:30. We have up above, we have BCI Studios. You can look up there. They're videotaping. And Bruno from BCI Studios sent me the link last night at about 12 o'clock, and I sent it out to all the choreographers, and I sent it to the dancers. So please, we will send it to you. And then also, we do have a, oops, I'm stepping on one of the mics. We do have one of the, we had a professional photographer come in during the dress rehearsal. So photographs have already been taken of the dancers, and you will have access to those. And she's an amazing photographer, so it's much better than what you can get on your phone. Besides, if you're taking pictures and you actually accidentally, you know, use a flash, you can blind the dancers and they can get injured. So we ask that you just refrain from doing video or photography. Yes? Thank you so much. And we hope that you thoroughly enjoy the show.
At this time, we ask that you silence or turn off your cell phones and to refrain from texting during the performance. Photography or video recording can be distracting and dangerous. hate those differences, and therefore, if you can, please be advised that there will be some stronger backstage at this performance. Finally, in the unlikely event of an emergency, please take a moment to relieve your nerves. Now, sit back and enjoy the performance.
Thank you. Yeah. Oh, it took me Hello. Hold up. Expectation shot to my heart. Thank you. Yeah. Deborah's daughter. Andrea. How are you?
She can be down here.
Thank you. happens to also be my grandma's birthday. So my cousin is going to come out. Yeah, they're going to be really hard.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm not the only kid to grow up this way. Surrounded by people who used to say that rhyme about sticks and stones. As those broken bones are more than the names we got called them all. So we grew up believing no one could fall in love with us. That we'd be lonely forever. That we'd never need someone to make us feel like the sun was something they built for us in their tool shed. So broken heartstrings and left the blues as we tried to empty ourselves so we would feel nothing. Don't tell me that it's less than broken bone. That an ingrown life is something surgeons can cut away, but there's no way for it to metastasize and die. She was 8 years old. Our first day of grade 3 when she got called ugly. We both got moved to the back of class so we would stop getting bombarded by spitballs. School halls were a battleground. We found ourselves outnumbered day after wretched day. We used to stay inside for recess because outside was worse. Outside we'd have to rehearse running away or learn to stay still like statues, even though the blues were there in grade 5. They taped a sign on the front of her desk that read, "Beware, dog." To this day, despite a loving husband, she doesn't think she's beautiful. Birthmark that takes up a little less than half her face. Kids used to say she looks like a wrong answer that someone tried to erase, but couldn't quite get the job done. And they'll never understand that she's raising two kids whose definition of beauty begins with the word mom. Because they see her heart before they see her skin, and she's only ever always been amazing. There's a broken branch grafted onto a different family tree. Adopted. Not because his parents opted for a different destiny. He was 3 when he became a mixed drink of 1 part left alone and 2 parts tragedy. Started therapy in 8th grade. Had a personality made up of tests and pills. Lived like the uphills were mountains and the downhills were cliffs. Or big suicidal, a tidal wave of antidepressants and an adolescence being called pop. 1 part because of the pills. 99 parts because of the cruelty. Killed himself in grade 10. The kid could still go home to mom and dad and have the audacity to tell him, "Get over it." As if depression is something that can be remedied by any of the contents found in a first aid kit. To this day, he has a stick of TNT lit from both ends. Could describe to in detail the way the sky bends and the moment before it's about to fall. And despite an army of friends who all call him an inspiration, he remains a conversation piece between people who can't understand. Maybe you used to bring bruises and broken teeth to show and tell, but never told. Because how can you hold your ground if everyone around you wants to bury you beneath it? You have to believe that they were wrong.
They have to be wrong. Why else would we still be here? We grew up learning to cheer on the underdog because we see ourselves in them. We stem from a root planted in the belief that we are not what we were called. Car stalled out and sitting empty on some highway. And if in some way we are, don't worry. We only got out to walk and get gas. We are graduating members from the class of we made it. Now the faded echoes of voices crying out names will never hurt me. Of course, they did. But our lives will only ever always continue to be a balancing act that has less to do with pain and more to do with beauty.
no, let him argue.
Get it tonight!
Tonight!
Be sure. synthesis is that wonderful feeling of physical and mental relaxation that can now spread throughout your entire body. Because from this moment in time, there's nothing of importance for you to do except relax.
Thank you.